What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. I'm Steven. This is Steven in Stereo, and you already know we are in for a treat. It's Harry Styles. It's live on the Today Show. I fucking love this man so much, and I'm so excited to see how much success he is getting off of Harry's House. I fucking love this album. Yes, it was so different, very unique in a lot of ways, especially when I think about who it's coming from. I just think it's really cool to see him experimenting and doing exactly what the fuck he wants to do with the music. So in today's video, we're going to be watching him do As It Was from the Today Show. I am not a channel that does sponsorships or advertisements. So all of my content is completely supported by my Patreon supporters. So in exchange for that, I do a lot of exclusive content when it comes to Harry Styles or One Direction or any of the members involved. I have so much on there. It's insane. But we did do a full reaction to Harry's House. We also did a full reaction slash watch party to the Zane Lowe interview, as well as the Coachella performances, as well as behind the album of Harry Styles 1. There's so much over there. If you're interested in checking any of those things out, as well as the future content for my man Harry Styles, the link is in the description. Thank you all so much for the support. I'm ready to dive into this because I don't even have to say it, just because. I'm digging this fit right now, though. Holding me back, gravity is holding me back. I want you to hold up the palm of your hand. Why don't we leave it at that? Two pieces to say here. One, I actually really like hearing this song live. I feel like it's so cool to get a chance to hear the band creating this track because this is a banger anyways. But obviously the music video, you know, we had Harry doing amazing Harry things, but we didn't have a lot of the band, right? And I for one am a huge fan of his band. Two, hearing the crowd scream it back to him is so amazing, and this is probably one of the most intimate settings that any of these people or any of us will ever have the privilege of seeing him in. Like, this is such a cool fucking way to experience this, because Harry is, of course, he's skyrocketing to the top right now, as if like we didn't expect that. Nothing to say. Tell us. Yo, Mitch is so cool. Can you imagine if like it's your graduation and like you're getting a chance to fucking like see him as a celebration? Like, I've seen Harry Styles once during the Love on Tour, and I will say that it was such an amazing fucking experience, and I was just celebrating life. Imagine if I was celebrating an actual thing. I don't think it would have changed it, actually. Now that I'm thinking about it, I'm kind of riffing here. I don't think it would have changed it. I think that what Harry delivered at that moment is more than I even expected. Yeah, celebration of life is enough for anything for him, honestly. Anything. Why are you sitting at home on the floor? What kind of pills are you on? Ringing the bell, nobody's coming to help. Your dad lives by himself. Just wants to know that you are. Oh, in this world, it's just there. You know it's not the same as it was. In this world, oh, it looks so much fun. It's just there. You know it's not the same as it was. Yes, kill it. Okay, so I obviously, from the first time we ever listened to this song anyways, I was obsessed with this part just because I definitely wasn't expecting it. hearing him do it live, I think makes it even cooler because he's such a fucking cool person. Like, his delivery in this is so calm and cool and collected, but I'm so jealous that, like, I can't reach that level of cool that he's at on this because, like, not only is he delivering it with such, like, swag, but, like, how do you also always sound perfect? Like, fuck, man, you're making it hard. Making it hard for us. You know it's not the same. In the rain, too. Oh, better headlines, feed in your head. I don't want to talk about the way it was. Oh. Hero, America, two kids, follower. I don't want to talk about his doing it first. Yes! As it was. You know it's not the same as it was. As it was. As it was. Oh, one more. Give me that again. As it was. Hey. Oh. Okay. Personally, maybe it's just me, I definitely prefer the live version of this track, even though I'm obviously a fucking fan of this song to begin with. I saw when this song first dropped, prior to the album ever being released, a lot of people had opinions that this wasn't that great of a song, or that it was like, it was just okay. You know what? I feel like some people really just like set the bar and their expectation is just whatever they want out of an artist. And so if anything else is delivered, they're going to find themselves underwhelmed. And I think that's what a lot of people did with this is I think that people were expecting a continuation of like, you know, Harry Styles 1/ like Fine Line. Like, I think they were expecting that kind of sound and like, yeah, to an extent I could see that, but like part of me also sees that like, I want artists that I like and artists that I love and support to continue to push whatever musical endeavor they're going to do that makes them, I guess, like feel fulfilled. Cause we're talking about artists that like, it's not about the money anymore. Like I don't think anybody can be able to really argue with that when it comes to Harry Styles. The guy made so much money from right here and from just like existing and like royalties and all that stuff. Like the man is set. So like at that point you do sit down and you go, what am I doing when it comes to writing this album? Am I writing an album because I want it to be number one? You know, sometimes, yeah, maybe you want those successes to go, but am I writing the album that I want? And then whatever accolades come after that, you know, they'll mean so much more. But ultimately, I have a way to experience my happiness. Well, that's what I got out of this. And of course, it obviously helped that I did a reaction to Zane Lowe's interview because it really put two and two together as to where Harry's mindset was going to be with this. So when this single dropped, I was fucking ecstatic. Why? One, I liked that he was experimenting with sounds that he had only like used briefly in some pieces. I liked the fact that I could find a genuine look of happiness about him. Something even different than the happy vibe he kind of always has. I saw a lot of pieces of Harry sort of being brought to life and expanded upon in much better ways. So when I saw him dancing around in that video for the first time, my heart just melted because I could tell that this was somebody who, despite all the success in the world, wanted to make whatever he wanted to make. Personally, the album is fucking amazing. And I feel like because of that, it has seen the success that it has. The album is extremely popular. I've seen it promoted everywhere. I see it consistently hitting numbers and doing these amazing things. And though that is not what he was out to do when he did this, that's exactly what happened for him. And I think it says a lot about why we should maybe sometimes just trust that the artist, you know, following their heart is going to be able to bring that passion. Is that the case every single time? No, there are albums or solo things that have happened in musical history that didn't turn out as well. But at the end of the day, if you're a fan of an artist, even if you don't necessarily like maybe a sound that they're doing, I think you can still respect, love, and appreciate. I just see all this negativity all the time, and I think it's hilarious because it's usually from people that literally couldn't make any music to save their lives, talking about how artists are good or bad or whatever. It's like, shut up. Like, just enjoy the moments. It's okay to have those opinions, but it's so interesting to me how people are so loud when they don't like something. And like, they're so fucking quiet whenever something is good or when they appreciate something or like something. Or they're worse. They find something that they really love and then they just shit on everybody else in the world who doesn't like those things. So I feel like we are in a wonderful time when it comes to music. I feel like if people would open up their minds a little bit, you can find some really great stuff. I have learned that so much in my 4 years of doing YouTube, that there are so many amazing artists that are out there to discover. Harry Styles, I'm so fortunate that he was one of the artists that I chose. One day on the trending page, I was like, oh, I've heard of this guy before. I thought it was going to be something different. And what happened is, well, a lot of you know the story. I've listened to Harry Styles. I listened to a bunch of his stuff. I fucking ended up getting into One Direction because of that. I did all their stuff. And I did all the solo albums from all of the artists in One Direction. And yeah, it's very fair to say that I am a fan of this band. I will stand up for this band in conversation numerous times because you got to explain to people sometimes, like, you can't just like denounce a band strictly because you think that they are whatever this genre is that you're labeling it as. So a little bit of a rant. I usually only do those on Patreon, but I can't help myself with this because I feel like this is a celebration. And like, even though I feel like, you know, we're in the rain, there's maybe it's cold. I don't know when this was actually recorded, but like, you're in the rain, like, you know, the weather can be kind of if, and you're outside performing this, like there could be a lot that could go wrong, but like everybody seems to be having such a fucking amazing time screaming these words back to Harry. And like, even though he seems a little bit reserved in part of the verses on this, he gets to the chorus and he just like, all the fucking energy comes back. And the fact that he actually did his dance on stage, again, amazing. I know he's been performing this a lot. I know he's been touring, doing all of these like performances and stuff with this, but like to see that like love and passion for this song still radiates, especially anytime he gets to that part where he gets to dance, I'm just like forever grateful of this man, because I feel like what he's doing is something amazing. And I really hope that I get a chance to see him again, because I feel like he's one of those people, like you see him once and you leave there going, oh, I need to see that dude again. So like, yes, you guys need to support Harry Styles if you like him. If you don't, that's fine. There's no need to fill your entire Twitter feed about it, because it's honestly kind of weird and like super toxic. And nobody wants to really be toxic, right? Maybe you do, but I don't. So I love this dude and I love the song and I think his performance is great. And Mitch always looks cool with his beanie and I fucking love the band. I love everything about this. And I just like, I feel like this is where I want to experience this the next time I see him. Like, wouldn't it be so cool to be at the Plaza, to be downtown? You're already in New York. You're having the time of your life and you get a chance to see him perform and you stand in the rain. Like, it's fucking so romantic. So, okay. I love you guys. I will see you in the next one. Peace.